Hello students, welcome to the class of Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering. So the main aim of this subject is to understand the fundamental principle of electrical engineering and to provide an overview of evolution of electronics and communication engineering. Okay, so this subject consists of 6 modules. Okay, so the first module, it is aiming to apply the fundamental concepts and circuit law to solve in DC circuits. Okay, so the first module is focusing to apply the fundamental concepts and the circuit laws to solve in a DC circuit. Okay, so we can see the first module first. Okay. So before that, the electrical engineering is a branch of engineering that study about the devices and system that uses electricity, electronics and electromagnetism. So this is the electrical engineering. So it's a branch of engineering that study about the devices and systems that uses electricity, electronics and electromagnetism. So first of all, let us see some of the basic quantities and their definitions and their units. Okay, so we can start with the types of voltage. So we know there are two types of voltage, DC voltage and AC voltage. DC means direct current and AC means alternating current, right? So in DC, the magnitude and direction does not change with time, right? And in AC, the magnitude and direction will change with time, right? So if we are plotting a graph, so across time, and let us draw the voltage. So this is the curve for a DC voltage, that is the magnitude and the direction will not change with respect to the time. And if we are drawing a graph for AC voltage with respect to time, it is alternating voltage, right? The magnitude as well as the direction will change with respect to time. Okay, so this is the two types of voltages, direct voltage and AC, alternating voltage, or direct DC supply and AC supply. Okay, so the first module, as I said, we are dealing with the DC circuits. So let us see about DC circuit. Okay, so I am drawing a DC circuit, a simple DC circuit. So let us draw the source as a battery, and I am connecting it to a lamp. Okay, so this is the lamp, this is a battery source, and we are connecting to the lamp with use of connecting wires. Okay, so a combination of circuit elements to form a closed path for the flow of current is known as DC circuit. So circuit consists of a combination of circuit elements to form a closed path for the flow of current. So since it is a closed path, a current will be flowing through this path. Let us represent it by current I. Okay, so the three circuit elements are battery, second one is the lamp, and third one is the connecting wires. So this DC circuit consists of three elements: battery, lamp, and connecting wires. So the battery acts as a source. So the battery here acts as source, and the lamp acts as load. Load means any device that consumes electrical energy is called as load. So the lamp acts as load and the battery here acts as a source of supply. Okay, so now let us see about active and passive elements. Active and passive elements. What do you mean by active element? Active element. Active element means the elements capable of generating energy. Elements capable of generating energy is called as active element. And passive means the elements not capable of generating energy. Okay, so example for active elements, we can say battery. They produce energy, so we can say battery or generators. Okay, and for passive elements, they are elements that is not capable of generating energy, rather sometimes they consume or store energy. We can say example resistors or inductors or capacitors. Okay, are the examples for passive elements. That is, resistors will be consuming the electrical energy and inductors and capacitors will be storing the energy in their magnetic as well as capacitive energy. Okay, so we have discussed about the active and passive elements. Now let us see about the other basic quantities, that is starting with electric current. So electric current, it is represented by capital I. It is the rate of change of charge, right? Current is the rate of change of charge, that is I is equal to, we can say, dq by dt. The charge is represented by q, or I is equal to q by t. The rate of change of charge is known as current. Okay, so its unit is charge, its unit is coulomb, and time, its unit is second, coulomb per second or ampere, which is represented by capital A. Okay, next one is the potential or V. Okay, it is the work done to move a unit charge from infinity to that point. So potential is the work done to move a unit positive charge from infinity to that particular point. So V is equal to work done by charge Q, and its unit is volts, which is represented by capital V. So next is the potential difference. What do you mean by potential difference? So it is the work done to move a unit positive charge from one point to another. It is the work done to move a unit positive charge from 1 point to another. So it is also the unit is volt. Okay, the potential difference between two points. Next we can say about EMF, that is the electro motive force. Okay, so it is the force which causes current to flow in electric circuit. It is the force that causes current to flow in an electric circuit. So its unit is also volt. Okay. Now let us see about resistance. Resistance. So you know, resistance is the property of a material to oppose the flow of current. Right, it is a property of the material to oppose the flow of current. Its unit is ohm. Okay, and the resistance depends upon four factors. It depends the resistance of a conductor depends upon four factors. Okay, the first one is the type of the material. First one is the type of the material, that is example silver. So silver is a better conductor than copper, right? So it depends upon the type of the material. Second one, it depends upon the length of the conductor, that is resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor. The third one is the area that depends upon the area of the conductor. So R is inversely proportional to the resistance, is inversely proportional to the area. And the fourth factor is the temperature. Okay, so for conductors the resistance value increases as temperature increases, and for insulators or semiconductors, as temperature increases the resistance decreases. That is, for conductors the resistance is positive, and for insulators or semiconductors the dependency is reverse. Okay, that is, we can say it is positive temperature coefficient. They have conductors having positive temperature coefficient. Okay, and for insulators and semiconductors it is negative temperature coefficient. Okay, so we can say that is resistance is directly proportional to, from this, R is directly proportional to L by A. That is, R is equal to, we can say, rho L by A. Where rho is the resistivity. Rho is the resistivity of the material, and we can, from this equation we can write rho is equal to R A by L, right? So when area is equal to 1 meter square and length is equal to 1 meter, then we can say rho is equal to R, right? So if we want to say the unit of rho, that is resistance unit is ohm, area's unit is meter square, and divided by length unit is meter. That is equal to ohm meter. So the unit of resistivity, where rho is called as the resistivity of the material, the unit of rho is given by ohm meter. Okay. So next, let us see Ohm's law. So Ohm's law states that at constant temperature, the current flowing through the conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference across the terminals. So Ohm's law states that the current flowing through the conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across the terminal. Okay, so that is I is equal to V by R. The proportionality can be changed by using I is equal to V by R, where R is the resistance of that material. So from this we can write V is equal to I into R, okay, or R is equal to V by I, or we can write I is equal to V by R. So we can formulate three equations from the Ohm's law, where R is the resistance of that conductor. So Ohm's law states that at constant temperature, the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the voltage, or is directly proportional to the potential difference across that terminal. So we can write I is equal to V by R, where R is the resistance of that conductor. Okay. So next, let us see about conductance. So we have discussed about resistance, now we can say about conductance and conductivity. Okay, conductance and conductivity. So the property of a conductor which allows the passage of current is known as conductance. So conductance is the property of the conductor to allow the passage of current. Resistance is the property of the conductor to oppose the flow of current. Then conductance is the property of the conductor to allow the passage of current through it. Okay, so we can say conductance we are representing by G. So the conductance is the reciprocal of resistance. Conductance is the reciprocal of resistance. So we can write G is equal to 1 by R. The conductance is represented by G. Conductance is the inverse of resistance. Therefore, we can write G is equal to 1 by R. So we know R is equal to rho L by A. Then that is G is equal to A by rho L. That we can write sigma A by L. Okay, where one A sigma is the is equal to, where sigma is equal to 1 by rho, and sigma is called as the conductivity. Sigma is called as the conductivity of the material, or that conductor. Conductivity of the conductor. The unit of conductance, unit of conductance G is equal to, we know, 1 by R. So R the unit and then ohm, that is 1 by ohm, or we can say ohm inverse, or we can say it is called as mho. Okay, ohm inverse or mho. And the unit of conductivity, the unit of conductivity sigma is equal to, so from here we can write sigma is equal to, from this equation sigma is equal to G L by A. So the unit of G is mho, that is conductance is mho into, the unit of length is meter by the unit of area is meter square. So that is equal to mho by m. Okay, so that is the unit of conductivity. Okay, thank you.